first thing, I'd like you all very much if you occupy the front row. Because I don't want you to move to the front in the between. Because you will find the lecture the most interesting and the most important lecture of your life. Evidence-based practice. I don't want the delegate to move in between when I am taking the lecture. Okay? And I want interaction and I want to listen to what you tell. I don't believe my hearing abilities that I can listen from the last row. So if you really want to interact with me, you can come to the front. I'll give you a minute, no problem. Without making noise, as usual. Just come to the front. Okay? I'll be delighted to have you in the front. I'm not going to tell you to be silent. Okay, because I believe you are professionals and you will behave professionally in the auditorium. Absolutely fine. I wish you all good luck. We'll begin today. And I'm great. I'm greatly delighted to have you all here. Okay. I am Senthil Kumar. I'm an assistant professor in Mansoor Senthil and Manotherapy. I am that person. I'm not a PhD. I'm doing PhD. It's within bracket. Okay. I'm from Sathavamiki College, Bangalore. I'm presenting on evidence-based practice in the physical management of hip and knee disorder. We'll see what is this. I greatly acknowledge the help and the cooperation rendered by my HOD and the team from the South Asian Cochrane Network, Manipal University site, and my BD students and colleagues and my patients. Most important, my objective of this presentation, at the end of this presentation, I want you all to remember this following terms which I am putting in the slide. And if you just remember these terms, at the end of the presentation, I have done my justice and you also would have done your justice. First thing, I am going to give some links of the website where you can search for evidence. Okay? And the next is, we are going to see what are the steps. There are 5 steps in the evidence-based practice. So we will see those 5 steps. What are the steps? And then next thing we are going to see is the level of evidence. We tell the highest level of evidence, lowest level of evidence. Evidence recommendation is like this. You will find in numerous journal articles and also textbook nowadays is coming evidence. So that is the, so that I want you to definitely remember. The next thing is most important term, clinical reasoning, where for whatever you do, there is always a question, you know, why you are doing it? Why not the other treatment options? Okay? So always that answers to everything will be given only by clinical reasoning. So I want you to know the term and remember the term alone. If you don't know what it is, no problem. And the next term which I want all of you to remember is the biopsychosocial model, where you treat the patient as a holistic aspect. You don't treat only the patient as a group of a tissue. Okay, it's psychological and also social implications to any pathology is there. So that term biopsychosocial model deserves importance. Okay. This presentation I have uploaded in the website. It's a direct link to the presentation. This PowerPoint presentation is in the web. You can put this link and you can download the PowerPoint presentation and you can note it down anything at any time. You can tell your friends also. There is absolutely no restraint. Why I am putting this link is because I don't want you to write down now. Okay? The whole presentation is there in the web. So kindly note it down. After the file it is /13795807/1B04F/E96. /ebphk.psk.html and this link, if you don't want it, also no problem. If you could just give me your email ID, I'll send it to your email ID. This link I'll send it to you. You can always download anytime. Okay. We'll proceed to the main presentation. Fine. Shall we?
Yeah.
One case has come, for example, in your department. A 60-year-old man with a chronic pain in the right hip. He's complaining, right hip, very serious pain, chronic pain. I don't know how it started. It is insidious onset. And he comes to the department for treatment. What do you actually think? What can be the problem with this patient? Old man, right side, hip pain. What do you think? First diagnosis. OA hip. Okay, correct. 100% you are right. What will be the treatment? What will be the treatment? Short wave like me, very good. Okay, fantastic. Another case, a 20-year-old girl comes. Okay? Imagine that it's our own student only, because physiotherapists are you know how much fit they are. Okay? They develop all kinds of problems before solving other problems. And she comes with complaints of pain and the clicks in the knee joint, both the knees of inferior joints again for treatment. What do you think? Clicks are the clicks and pain. Clicks and pain, pain in the anterior aspect of the knee joint. Why? Yeah, chondromalacia patella. Okay, chondromalacia, chondrosigapus, anything. So treatment, what will be the treatment? Ultrasound will give then, IFT, tens you cannot give, taping you cannot give, exercise you cannot give, surgery you cannot give, which one you cannot give? Laser? Any modality which you cannot give? What tenses you will say in treatment? What tenses? You see, how are you going to decide? You have decided that the first patient was OA treatment, you gave short wave. The second patient you decided is chondromalacia patella and you gave ultrasound. And the patient improves. Both the patients improve. What do you think? Patients are improved. What do you think? Why? Because my knowledge is right. Whatever I have knowledge now, I am right. 100% I am right. So whatever I did, patient improved. Do you agree? The next option, my experience, my past experience was right. Okay, because earlier I have treated chondromalacia patella with ultrasound. So I gave ultrasound. So past experience was right. And the next, my technique should be right. Okay, whatever I use as a technique should be right. It is always right. Okay, you always think like this. Egocentric decision making, you know, when you think yourself, okay, I am always right. You don't think patient improved because of the pathology's behavior. You don't think any other issues addressing the improvement. You think it's all you who created the improvement, you know, it's like that. Patient did not improve, what do you think, first reason? What do you think? We think egocentric. We tell, technique is wrong. Maitland told the mobilization, I think Maitland is wrong. I use the glide. Technique is not working. Technique, something is wrong. Mulligan, I don't know, he's a fool only. Why he told mobilization is a movement and a part movement, part mobilization. I may be wrong. Not that I am wrong, maybe. Maybe.
Some very few percentages, you know, I may be wrong. Then you think what to do. Finally, whom to blame. And finally, what do you tell? Exactly, the answer came already, someone told. Something definitely wrong with the patient. Definitely something is wrong. Still the patient is telling pain only. Is there any solution to this kind of patient making? What are we going to land by thinking all these things? When a patient comes with hip pain, you think, why is it, but you give short hair? No. Pain and click, chondromalacia patella, you give ultrasound and then you just end the treatment, you don't know what happened to the patient. Patient improves or not improves, you just give a reason. Just to explain your own seniors, all your juniors. Finally, you are not treating everyone, you are only treating yourself and your profession because you don't know what is happening. And you go to the next part of this.
If you are considering about the technique, what are we to think about the technique? We think of evidence supporting the technique. If the technique is having proper evidence, okay, evidence means has anyone studied about this technique on earlier on patients? Similar patients have they studied or not? The biomechanics of the technique, physiological and the therapeutic effects of a particular technique which you use, the indications of the technique, the procedure how the technique is performed, the dosage most important because you cannot give the technique for everyone. Each patient has to be individualized. You need a particular dosage. So there should be a study or a published literature which should tell this is the proper dosage for this pathology. Without that, how can you give? If you don't have a detail, you have to do a study on what is the exact better dosage for treatment of chondromalacia patella. Ultrasound, how much wattage is important.
how much intensity is important. So you should do a study. Progression. After starting the first day, second day, what to do? We will see if the patient comes on the second day. Where he is going to come? Okay? And the technique compared to other treatment techniques,
how much it is important? How much is it you are going to give any kind of clinically significant improvement in the patient? You need to have evidence for all this. Therapist, thinking about therapist, what do you think? Clinical reasoning skills of the therapist, beautiful term, clinical reasoning. As a clinician, you should have reasoning for what you are doing, clinical reasoning.
Depends on the knowledge and the qualification, an undergraduate, postgraduate, you know, PhD, there's never ending qualifications now in the list of physiotherapy. You see, external workshop training programs, so many knowledge is there. Experience, clinical postings experience, your work experience, private practice experience, everything is experience only. Inside the conference hall experience, outside the conference hall experience, everything is experience. Your decision making skills in terms of how you are going to decide the particular treatment or the modality. Your communication ability, because you need to get the history and the subjective examination details. You have to assess. For getting the details out of the patient, you need the skills to communicate. And the next one, communication ability, when you are communicating with your other professionals. If you are going to talk to the orthopedic surgeon, or you are going to talk to any of your superior or your inferior, your nurses, you are going to communicate the positioning advice or anything, whatever it is, how you are going to effectively communicate. Your understanding is called as recognition. Your understanding about all these processes is called as recognition. And metacognition determines what is called as your understanding of your own understanding. Am I understanding in the best possible manner? That question has to be answered. Okay? I am understanding. Okay. But is this way of understanding the best? Understanding of your own understanding, that is metacognition, is the highest level of brain function which definitely I don't think any of us will be using. Okay? Because we don't want it to work hard. Patient, thinking about patient, what do you think? Biopsychosocial attitude, another beautiful word, which is now in the recent advance, which is exploding in the world, okay, all around the globe. In the recent advance, physical and physiological is contributed as the biological. That is to do with the body, okay, biological. The mind and the present mental state or the association of the pathology with respect to stress is called as a psychological attitude. And the influence of the community. For example, here also there are multiple communities. Like one community of physiotherapists, another community of orthopedic surgeons. These are ergonomic communities. You have another community of age-wise communities. And the same way you have sex-wise communities, gender-wise, okay? You have multiple communities. You have communities with respect to region, you know, Tamil Nadu, outside Tamil Nadu, okay? There are various communities. So people are influenced by the presence where they are in the community. Some may stay in the level ground, some may stay in the hill station. Everything will be, the culture, the rules, the rurals and everything will be different between them. So on one hand, what do you do? One side you see, there is an unlimited increase in the levels of evidence. There has been an increasing number of studies. Every day minimum 150 journal articles are published in physiotherapy. Every year, the articles on physiotherapy is getting doubled in the last 3 years. Evidence is increasing like anything, that we physiotherapists, what I feel is, how are we going to get all this evidence? Where we are going to get all this evidence? How we are going to practice? We are not able to read textbooks only, how we are going to read journals. Okay? On the other hand, you see, the other practitioners, they look at only the evidence, they don't look at the patient. They ignore the patient. They keep looking at the records, they keep looking at the published journals. They treat the x-ray, they don't treat the patient. Degeneration will be there in the x-ray. Patient will not have any symptom. Will you keep charging? No. What is there? One day 100 rupees, one sitting, who does? No. Okay, I want to have something. Business no practice. Business based practice. Okay? So what we are going to see in this presentation is actually the overview. That is, what is evidence-based practice? The steps in evidence-based practice. And then we are going to see the highest level of evidence recommendations for the physiotherapy treatment in the hip joint. Again, what is called the level 1DA evidence. And similar highest level of evidence for the physiotherapy treatment in the knee joint. That will end my presentation, okay? Only four. Very simple. In the evidence-based
ethics-based practice is a definition which says everything about what is actually an ethical practice. That means it's a conscientious and explicit use of current research evidence, that is current, okay, what is yesterday, what is today, okay, integrating with the personal expertise. You need to have expertise. Without expertise, you cannot just use the evidence, okay, and patient preferences. You are an expert, evidence tells that you are going to use the technique or you are going to use that machine. Patient tells, I cannot pay the amount. Will you give free treatment or what? We are not doing free treatment at all. That is out of question. I paid so many lakhs to get my master's. Why I should give free treatment? Okay? Towards the management of the patient. That is the definition of evidence-based practice. The steps in evidence-based practice, remember, I have put in the code. Whichever I have put in the code, the heading, I want you all to be remembering that. The points to remember I have told. Okay, take home messages, the 5 points. Formulation of a person. When you are treating a patient, you should formulate one person. Why is this treatment effective? Why other treatments are not effective? How do you say this is a diagnosis? For everything, there is a question. Once you get the question, you try to search for evidence for that question. On confirming this diagnosis based on the clinical features, are there any studies, any proof, any evidence? And then, after searching for the evidence, what you do is you appraise the evidence. That means, what type of study it is. Is it an important study? Is it a study done on Indian subjects? You know, because you cannot apply studies which are done on American subjects or Indian subjects. Because there is a huge variability in the population. There are various limitations. And after appraising the evidence, you should apply the evidence to practice. It's easy. So, first thing is, formulation of a question. Next is, next is search for evidence. Next is appraisal of the evidence. Next is application of the evidence to practice. After applying, what you should do? Take the piece, send the patient. No, you have to measure the outcome. You have to see what is the outcome of this evidence-based practice. After using it, how is the patient? Okay, outcome assessment. That is the fifth step of evidence-based practice. Next slide will go. What can be the types of questions when you are treating hip and knee disorders? The questions can be categorized into type of patient. Why OA hip alone respond? Why not a dislocation of hip? Depending on the patient characteristics, you can have a question. And why a 60-year-old responds but not a 40-year-old? It's a patient characteristic, age. It can be an intervention, like as I said, short wave. Why short wave is effective? Why not ultrasound? That's an intervention question. Outcome is the pain improving in the patient, or is the range of motion improving in the patient? Or, as we saw in the video earlier, yesterday, functional improvement. So that's what the patient is coming to us for. No, he is unable to squat. He has come to you for treatment. You give him the treatment and you tell him not to squat. What is the big thing in this? Patient will tell, I am not able to squat, I came to this doctor, he told not to squat. Is that a treatment? Patient has to become functionally independent, remember that. Give the best possible treatment. Do not be ignorant. Comparison between two types of patients, comparison between two types of outcomes, or comparison between two types of interventions. It could be any of the studies. Question. So in the hip joint, you may see patients like OA, RA, or THR patients. Patient characteristics. Interventions you can maybe explain, is it effective or not, short wave is it effective or not. Comparison, as I discussed earlier. Outcomes you can see, hip joint you can see, gait, range of motion, strength of the hip, functional improvement, etc. Knee you will find THR, soft tissue injuries. The next topic, patellofemoral pain syndrome, OA. Intervention you can range from exercise, manotherapy and also physical modalities. Comparisons and also pain, gait, range of motion and strength as the outcome. Okay? You can have varying range of questions, depends on the therapist who is treating the patient, which is the predominant clinical problem. Whether the pathology is the problem, or the treatment has to be effective, or the comparison is the question. For example, some modalities in combination will be better than using it individually. That means the comparison. We are trying to find out the effective, comparative effect. And the outcome, sometimes elderly patient, for them range of motion or pain is not going to improve, it's not a significant outcome. Functional improvement is important. Because the patient wants to die walking. No, I have to be walking till my death. I cannot just lie down bedridden.
deposit. So functional improvement is important. And for sports people, return to activity is important. Okay? So it's very important that you consider the outcome with respect to the patient's goal. Search for evidence, again within quotes, the slide of your life.
Okay, where are the web links? One of the common one, we use Google for everything else, we don't use for academic, if you consider journal articles. There is one called as scholar.google.com. It's a useful site. You are noting it down or not, no problem. Anyway, the presentation is there in the web. PubMed.com, I think the PG should be familiar about this. You might be searching for abstract, you'll get. Pedro, it's the physical therapy evidence database of Australia, University of South Australia, where our fellow physiotherapists, many of them, they graduated from the same institute in Australia. CEBP, Center for Evidence-Based Physiotherapy, there is one website where it gives full text articles of all what is called as randomized control trials. Again, I will be telling you what is this. Okay, randomized control trials, which are considered to be the best type of study design when you are trying to compare two treatments. Okay, you put the patient into the treatment without your knowledge. Randomly you put them into the treatment groups.
Okay, randomized control trial. You might have one group without treatment and one group with the ultrasound. To say the one with the ultrasound improved better than the one which was given nothing. If the one which was given nothing also improved, then you can say ultrasound is not the one which is causing the improvement. Because self-improvement is there. The pathology automatically improves. Okay? So randomized control trials, full text is there in the CEBP.nl. And then another most important site is the Cochrane Library. You have heard about the Cochrane collaboration. And this library is available fully open access, that means full text PDF, right from January 2007. Because of ICMR, which funded this subscription, All India. So from any website, any internet browsing center, you can access this website and you can search and you can get the materials fully free. Because India is still in the list of developing countries. So we need to take privilege in taking these opportunities by being a developing country also. But in another 10 years, we may not be in the developing country. Okay, for the development that's happening in all our professions, we will be developed. Okay. Other websites which are less important, but still useful, one is findarticles.com, and the next is medscape.com. So we saw scholar.google.com, PubMed.com, Pedro, CABP, Cochrane Library, Find Articles, and Medscape. Scholar.google.com, when you type, the page comes like this. Yes? It's same as the Google, and then you put the search terms, for example, knee and physiotherapy, hip and physiotherapy. Yes? If you put hip and physiotherapy, you are getting 5,800 hits. That's what you tell you. 5,800 hits in terms of the link. You will find these links. You know, these are the links. And when you click on this link, this is knee joint, 6,660 articles on the knee and physiotherapy. Once you click on the link, the journals abstract all the full text open to the journal's respective website. Okay?
So you might get the abstract, some journals are full text or free, so you can get it from the full text link in the right. Okay? PubMed, when you go to the page, appears like this. Knee and physiotherapy is 2728 citations in PubMed, and hip and physiotherapy, 1446 abstracts in PubMed. So when you click on this respective link, you will get the abstract in the PubMed. Pedro, the physical therapy evidence database, the page appears like this. You can select depending on the body part, depending on the specialty, depending on the intervention, or depending on the type of the study design. There are categories to choose, and once you choose, and then put the term, you can select hip or thigh, okay? Or lower leg or knee, okay? Thigh and hip yielded 522 abstracts of randomized control trials.
And knee joint yielded 930. The advantage of being in the Pedro is all these trials are scored. They are scored for their quality. Whether it's high quality or low quality, out of 11, it's 0 to 11 scale, they have scored, they have a set criteria. So scores above 7 are considered to be high quality RCT. So you can see the score and you can see whether to interpret from that evidence or not.
That's the advantage. And then the abstract open. Okay, after clicking on the link. See, VP, the page appears like this. You can go to the search option, you'll get this. And you'll type there, knee joint, hip joint. Hip is 53 full text RCT, randomized control trial, highest level of evidence in the CVP. And the knee joint is 82 in the CVP.
And when you click on this author name or text name, you'll get an option of open or to save. If you put save option, you can save it to the computer or you can open the file and you can read it on the web or you can copy it and take print. Okay, multiple options. Cochrane library, the page appears like this. Go to search option here. You can type hip yields 6. What is this 6? This Cochrane library is famous for systematic reviews. Okay, systematic reviews mean it's a study of all the studies. You have multiple studies, there are millions of studies. It's a study of all the studies.
But they are studied based on just set criteria, systematic way. So you review all the studies and then you give a conclusion. Because you may see one RCT telling that the treatment is effective, another RCT telling that the treatment is not effective. You will find. So when a review is done, you will get the best conclusion. So, Cochrane library has been set up systematic reviews. The systematic reviews of randomized control trials. Okay, so, they review only the randomized control trials and they put the conclusion. Okay? These Cochrane systematic reviews are the level 1A. And the randomized control trials are the level 1B. We will see them anyway now. So, Cochrane library, if you research, knee is 66 systematic reviews. And then the page opens with the full text in HTML in the right side and the PDF link in the left. So when you click on that, the PDF file opens the full text of the PDF document or the systematic review with all references to all the studies on this topic, particular topic. For example, continuous patch and motion, we commonly use following total knee arthroplasty. Whether it is useful or not, if you have a doubt, put the search, you'll get it and it says it's effective and then you use it. Okay? What is evidence-based practice, and then you can save it to the system. This is the most important slide where we see we appraise the quality of the study depending on the study design, type of study design, and we see in the lowest one test tube research, that means laboratory research. You know, like tissue, ultrasound is thick tissue. You know, you give thick tissue penetration ultrasound, is it required for our tissue? Never. Human being thick. Maybe biology may say similarity, but we don't accept. Okay? And animal research, again, take, okay? Editorials and opinions. For example, I might give some opinion, any other philosophical will give opinion. That is actually not the highest level of evidence. But you see, the bottom ones are more in number. Laboratory studies will be more in number. Animal research is more in number. Okay? Ideas are more in number. Always we are ready for ideas. Okay? Whether we are ready to listen or not, we will always give them ideas. Okay? And we see case reports, that is single case studies. You might report a case, whatever you have done, you might respect. But that one case, is you cannot generalize for all patients. One exception can always be there, we should have improved. Okay? Case series is a group of patients, 15 to 20 patients, they come, you treat them, and then you say, all these patients I used this technique and it was effective. Okay, case series. Series of cases. Okay? And then you have case control studies. Case control means the ones with pathologies compared versus the ones without pathologies. Cases control. Okay? Normals, they respond. Pathologies also respond. Then you can think of preventive intervention. Because normals are also showing improvement. You can give it as a preventive intervention. Okay? Cases are not improving, controls are improving. Why to apply it on patients? It's only useful as a prevention. Cases are improving, then definitely you can use it on patients. But here only thing is, the patient is not randomized. That means, the intervention what you are using, I might choose, okay, this patient I will give this intervention. That patient I will give another intervention on my own basis.
For example, I am a man of service. I am comparing man of service versus other terms. Okay? In Kanra Malaysia Patala. What I do is, a 25-year-old boy comes. I put him in man of service group. 60-year-old man comes. I put him in? Ultrasound group. Because I know that he is not going to improve. So I put him in the group. So there is a lot of what is called as bias. You might know what is happening and you might directly or indirectly influence the results of the study. Okay, that is the disadvantage with low quality studies, with case control studies. And the next type of studies are the cohort studies, where you really see cohort means a group of community, group of people. Okay, you are in their own environment. Physiotherapist is a cohort. Girls are a cohort, you know. It is elderly is a cohort, men are a cohort, athletes are a cohort, because they are all communities in their own world. Physiotherapists, you know, they are in their own world, because they never come out of their world. Okay? Unless you see the highest level of evidence, randomized controlled trials, where the therapist is not knowing what is happening, except he is providing the intervention. Even intervention also you can give without knowing what is happening. Okay, that is also happening. So, the patient is put in the group randomly. You might take a chip or you might put a toss of a coin, okay, whichever comes you might give the treatment, okay? And it's a randomization order, or out of all of you I want to give some lecture and I want to see the effect of the lecture. Then what I should do is take a random people of 10. I cannot choose all those who are sitting in the first row. If I select only those who are sitting in the first row, what will happen? What will happen? They'll be definitely listening because they are here. Last month may not. Okay? That is one option. Another option.
The first row ones will be having neck pain because they are looking up. The last one will also be having neck pain because they are looking down. Okay? There are many bias. So I should create a random sample out of all of you to study anything. That is what is randomization. So either sampling or the treatment method should be randomized. What is called actually randomized controlled trial. And here what is called as blinding is there. Blinding means it's not that we tie our eyes and the patient also is blind and we both keep touching. Okay? I don't think it's not like that. Blinding means I am not aware of the method of the randomization and I am also not aware how the outcome will be measured. Because I may treat, I should not measure the outcome. I may give the manual therapy, I may give the ultrasound. But the pain visual analog scale or verbal rating scale is measured by someone else who do not know what treatment the patient got. If they know that manual therapy is given, and that the student is a student of mine who is very passionate towards manual therapy for some reason, and definitely that observer is likely to ask, yesterday your pain was 7, today it is 4 or 3. You won't ask today, what is the pain? Yesterday it was 7, today it is 4 or 3. Ultrasound probe. Yesterday it was 7, today it is 9 or 8. Bias. Okay? You influence the result in your question itself. Close-ended question. Okay? That's what happens when you don't do blinding. Okay? But these are highest quality studies which are actually not feasible. In clinical scenarios, sometimes you cannot blind. That is another drawback. In the right side, you see one vertical line that is called as the meta-analysis. Meta-analysis. Something to do with mathematics, which we all hate and we could not get any marks, that's why we are physiotherapy. And it's called as analysis of all analysis. You know, individual studies have done analysis.
Patients, 320 improved, 320 did not improve, they might tell. Analysis. So you take the analysis of each of the studies, club them all together, and do a cumulative analysis. That's called as the meta analysis. Study of all the studies is called as systematic review. And analysis of all analysis is called as the meta-analysis. Okay, these are the two terms which you remember, you will do some real informative justice. So, levels of evidence, 1A, the systematic review of the randomized control trials, 1B is individual randomized control trials, and 2A is systematic review of the cohort studies. Cohort means, I said, it's a community, it's a group of people. You are observing them, okay, over a follow up period of time, long period of time, so longitudinal study. Can be prospective or retrospective. Prospective means from today onwards to the future. Retrospective means past.
from documentation of the medical record, you may take the details and you may follow the master. How are the improvement of the TKR with the CPM in our department in the last 5 years?
Okay. Outcome research, depending on what type of outcome you are studying, that is 2C. 3A is systematic review of case control studies, that is the comparison between pathologies versus normal. 3B is individual case control studies and also poor quality RCTs. And the level 4 is the case series and also other descriptive studies where group of patients are seen and group of normals are treated or anything. And then last one comes expert opinion, laboratory studies and also case reports. The level 5 evidence. This is also within court. These levels of evidence are as per the recommendations of Center for Evidence Based Medicine. Okay? Which is universally acclaimed and validated. Okay, everyone uses this. Application of the evidence to practice depends upon availability of the treatment method. Just because extracorporeal short cell therapy is proved to be highly effective, can anyone of you give them extracorporeal short cell therapy? Will ask, what is this fellow talking? I don't know that machine also whether it is there or not. Okay, it costs around 32 lakhs. The piece of the equipment smaller size costs 14 lakhs. Okay? If that much lacks are there, what I'll start one nice college in outer some country outside the city, I'll start it and I'll form one autonomous, then in the future it will become deemed university, I'll be the dean. Why do I have that much money and get the machine?
No, that is the thing that is happening. Money. Absolutely, what I recommend is the knowledge and the proficiency of the therapist. Treatment method is there. I don't know how to use the shock wave. Shock wave is there just to apply the shock wave. That is not a question. You will get the shock of your life tomorrow. Then it will come back and it will sue you. You put the case. Not here in India. But there would have been, Dr. Nagan Commissioner, definitely would have seen abroad when he got, when he went, how much the ethical issues, legal issues are there. Any poor prognosis, the patient can sue you in the consumer court directly. Because it's become like a customer and a salesperson.
We are like that only, businessmen. You know, I have paid that much money, how much time I take to take my money back? Okay, I have paid 5 lakhs. So in 5 years I should get it back. You know, that is the business, what you are doing, practice. Affordability of the patient. You are telling, first sitting 300 rupees shock wave. Patient will get a shock wave. No, 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 I don't want the treatment.
I think pain is a little bit sensitive. I will come 1 week later. That's all. No issue. Patient cannot afford, you cannot give. Ultimately, what is important is collaborative reasoning. You talk with the patient, not talking about what is the movie which is going on in the next title. Okay? Yesterday, you saw the news that the Minister of the Government, not that talking, you communicate with respect to decision making for treatment. Okay? Let the decision come from the patient. Patient is important. You are taking the informed consent. What is ethically it is important for studies also, written informed consent. So, you have to collaborate with the patient and get to get the reasoning, what is called as the clinical reasoning, one of the clinical reasoning strategies where my teacher, he is sitting here, okay, Dr. Anand Jyoti sir, and he is an expert in clinical reasoning, okay, and it's important actually to
imply all those when you come to practice. Clinical reasoning, you try to weigh between the risk, the benefit, okay, in terms of what is the problem in the patient, right, or the dysfunction. What is the mechanism which is causing this dysfunction? Which structure is causing this pain? Patient is telling pain in the hip. Is it only from the joint? Or is it from the muscle? Or is it from the ligament? Is it from the fascia? Is it from the nerve? Is it from the blood vessels? Is it from the fascia? Is it from the bursa? Is it from the tendon? Is it from the bone? Multiple structures are there. Body is not only with joints. Never. Musculoskeletal system is not the only system which causes symptoms. You may get some serious pathology with the patient, and if you don't identify it, definitely you cannot answer your own conscience.
You will apply the short wave, next day the patient will come, and after 3 weeks you go for an investigation and they will find out that it's an osteosarcoma and you will go for amputation, and the patient will tell, well, earlier I didn't have any problems, but after the short wave I started developing symptoms. On what basis you gave the short wave? If you don't have the reasoning, you are going to be definitely in trouble, a lot of trouble. Contributing factors, like for example, ergonomic contributing factor, we saw yesterday one of the lectures, okay, ergonomics for computer users. So whatever you treat with the tissue, you might treat, but again the patient goes to the same job. It's the contributing consideration, add on to the methodology. Precautions and contraindications.
What is the likely precaution that you should take when you are using this treatment or contraindication in the pathology? What can be the associated comorbid pathologies, associated problems which the patient may have which might affect the improvement of the treatment response? You should always think. The mechanisms of the pain, what are all likely management possible, and you have to weigh the risks and benefits of each of the types of management, whether to manage or not, and what way it has to be managed. Prognosis. Again, how long is it going to take for the patient to come back to normal? The patient will ask you this question. Can anyone of you answer if someone asks you, sir, how many days did it take for me to get normal? You'll tell, first you do what I said. We'll see whether you are doing today only. If you do regularly, and then you come and ask me, I'll tell. No, sir, regularly if I do, 6 months will I be normal? No one can answer this question if you don't have clinical reasoning. Try to search this word in Google or Google Scholar anywhere, wherever it is. Try to get this information, try to get yourself trained in the skills. It will definitely help you in your evidence-based practice. Okay? So it's going to be all clinical reasoning. The term was actually introduced and it was explained better by Mark Jones, okay, who is from the same university, the University of South Australia. Okay? When you think of the patient, as we said earlier, biopsychosocial model, where the injury will lead to symptoms and the symptoms will lead to psychological changes. So you are all sitting here. You might think that you are all normal. You have one pain in the little finger you have, right little finger you have pain now. You think, started, I also got pain. I am treating everyone, pain here. Then next day, why for me alone pain is there? After 3 weeks also still very pain is there. Okay, I'll go for treatment. Your own colleague will show. They'll tell, pain is there, it will be there, what is there? Just try to modify your activity, avoid it. Avoid that. All these days I was doing the activity, suddenly they're telling me to avoid it. Will I be able to do the activity or not? Our own mind only, we are this much influenced by a little finger pain. Pain only it is. Remember, a patient who is having problems, who is undergoing investigation, who is especially undergoing a large surgery, can you expect the patient to be only biological? They are really psychological. Don't tell patient this. Yes. And their patient will tell outside. That's after this. Both of you will be telling both here and there, what will happen to the profession? All will be outcome assessment. Subjective outcomes, you can take pain. How is the pain? Okay, pre and post therapy, how is the pain? Range of motion you can take is more objective because we measure the. It's objective means it's taken by the therapist, subjective means it's given by the patient. Okay? Functional outcomes like squatting, cross leg sitting, we saw yesterday in the videos, remarkable improvement. We have some pre tests also like one leg hop, which you can use for hip and knee. And then lastly, we are going to see the levels of evidence recommendation. Ankylosing spondylitis hip was found to have supervised group physical pain to be highly effective rather than giving individual physiotherapy. Okay? So, if a physiotherapist is there in supervision and group physiotherapy is highly effective, and we do gait retraining and exercise for post-op hip fracture rehabilitation, anyway, the topic is yet to come. You can use post-op rehabilitation. That is inconclusive. It is not giving either in the positive or in the negative direction. It is inconclusive, still we need more research. And remember, preoperative education is important. In DHR, also in TKR, you educate the patient about the postoperative exercises or postoperative outcomes or about the pathology or about the surgery. Definitely, the reduced anxiety level will improve the patient's compliance in exercise program. Okay? So, very important, it's been shown to have 1A evidence, that is systematic review of randomized controlled trials, which was indexed in the Cochrane level. Knee joint. Bracing, sleeve, lateral weight control is effective for OA knee. Ice massage and core back. Nice, no, ice massage. Okay. CPM is useful for TKR. Tense is effective for OA knee. Pulse electromagnetic stimulation is also effective for OA knee. Exercise is effective for OA knee. Can you believe all this? Evidence supports our physiotherapy, my goodness. We didn't know all this. Aerobic exercise. is useful for why any? All these sequences are useful. Can I give you everything at the same time? Depends on the clinical reasoning. Acute phase you choose the modality which you can give acute. Chronic you choose the anabolic phase. Mobilization you use the chronic phase. Depends on the clinical decision making. You won't give you everything just because you use it. Not together. It has to be decision making has to be taken with clinical expertise. Very clear thing here? No problems? So EBP is what? It's the integration of clinical expertise, patient preferences, and research evidence. All the three when you integrate, you get a common goal that indicates evidence-based practice. When you are assessing your patient, try to develop some questions, search for evidence. After you acquire the best evidence, try to appraise the evidence for the quality of the evidence, and then you apply the evidence to practice. This is the brief outline of evidence-based practice, methods of evidence-based practice. Take-home message again. Web link. Do you remember Google Scholar then? PubMed? CEBP? Scholar.google.com? Metro? Cochrane Library. Beautiful. Okay? 5 steps in EBP. What are the 5 steps? First is formation of question. Next is search for evidence. Next is critical appraisal of the evidence. Beautiful. Then appraisal of the certain appraisal after application of the evidence. Beautiful. Then outcome assessment. Beautiful outcome. Okay? Fantastic. 5 levels of evidence. Level 1, level 2, 3, 4, 5. One is systematic review of randomized control trials. Fantastic, you are beautiful. You are beautiful. Okay? Something has happened to you. Okay? 1B. Individual randomized control trials. Beautiful. I know you know the rest. Clinical reasoning. You know the term clinical reasoning. Okay? It's the clinical expertise, your decision making skills. Biopsychosocial model. From tomorrow onwards, if you see anybody showing patient is like this, no, once you take them separately and you tell, if you develop a problem, what you will think? Okay? That is the main question. If they are able to answer, before blaming on someone else, try to analyze your own self. Once you know yourself, before telling about others. Okay? I am absolutely fascinated by the work which is done by the organizing committee here. We have come to the last slide actually, the most awaited slide of the morning. Okay, the thank you slide. I really, Varalakshmi ma'am and her team, Dr. Ranasamy sir and his team, they are a real good example of how orthopedic surgeons should be. Yes, sir is a role model for all the orthopedic surgeons. He deserves a very big round of applause. I think he deserves. Yesterday you saw in the first presentation also, what is evidence-based practice, we didn't have the term, okay? But you can see that article was there, okay, study was there, that level 3 recommendation was there, evidence. It's telling, negative effect was published. No one publishes negative. Journal editors do not publish negative results. Manual therapy, journal wants manual therapy positive results. Gwendolyn and Jules, she is a manual therapy editor. She wants positive results, negative results, no one publishes. Publication bias. And your college has a journal. Whatever students are doing, they publish. Whether the study is a good quality or not, no one reviews. So it depends on the evidence. So you saw evidence. And then you saw patients coming to serve with complaints of inability to squat and they were squatting at the end of the surgery. That is what is the point. You give the best to the patient. That is important. The power may go in the hall, but not in you. Okay? It is very important. The presentation is not the end. It is just the beginning that you have to start thinking about what you are going to do for yourself and for your profession by thinking about the three terms, that is evidence-based practice, which are seen in the studies and how they are followed. The reasoning skills, where you involve the teamwork, okay, collaborative reasoning with the patient, patient goals, the physiotherapist, teamwork. Sarah was always telling physiotherapist, nurse, okay? Everything we have to collaborate and he was making the decision. And you saw psychosocial model, you can see the patient smiling. Did you observe in the videos? The happiness with which they are walking. See the social model. It's not only that X-ray degeneration is there, I will do replacement. It's not like that. Psychosocial, what is the impact on the patient? What type of patient are we treating? Young patient or old patient? Social. Try to imply accordingly. And definitely you know, as nurse accident, he is a role model for all of us also, all the other patients also. And we have successful physiotherapists. My own teacher, okay, he is a physiotherapist. We are proud to have him as a fellow physiotherapist. We have all the other faculties also, they are all the best in the profession. They are all as role models. Stop blaming the physiotherapist. We always tell,
someone is not doing this, someone is not doing that. He is not worth for that, or not worth for that. Negative comments always we are free to give.
Look out for the people who are doing good. Try to appreciate them. Stop the negative comments. Look at the people who are doing good work. Encourage them. You are the best. That is the only difference between English and American. The encouragement and the motive is lacking. There are enough people to discourage, but remember, encouragement comes from within. Okay? Appreciate even if it is a junior, first year student who is asking a question, do not tell the student at this level that has all no need to know. You will keep quiet. Whatever question you are asking in your first year exam, you have to do massage only.
Ask the moment you do.
What is this?
Then what do you think? Oh, my intern is telling like this. I don't know what is the profession. Intern will go, faculty will say, what you are asking all these questions? You go and search. You see the textbook, why you are asking me? What is it? Nobody is doing anything. All negative comments. What is the solution? Nothing. Nowhere. And you can see, if there is a way that exists, you can walk. If there is no way, what is it do? Create a way. Not that you can stand. Just keep standing, just watching. Someone will create a way, someone let them walk after they follow. That is only following. You want to be a leader or a follower? How many times you want to take the applause? You want to give the applause or take the applause? That is the difference. Okay? Remember, we either find a way or make one. That is actually proven by practice. Okay? And also remember, if evidence does not exist, does not mean, the absence of evidence does not mean it's the evidence of absence. Okay, you cannot assume that there is nothing supporting exercise. So exercise is not useful. You have to do a study. If evidence is not there, you create the evidence. And then someone can apply it for practice. Okay? And definitely the most important words of my life. I really thank you all for the cooperation that you rendered for my lecture. And you are a very beautiful crowd. Okay?